Today we are going to sign up for Fusion personal use. So let's get cracking. Step one is to find it. I'm going to simply search Fusion personal use. It gives you a link where you can get there in a heartbeat. Step one is to check the terms and conditions. It's personal, non-commercial products only, limited to individuals generating less than $1,000 annually, and not for use in primary employment, company environments, or commercial training. There is more information down below. Of course, you can check out what it costs for a full year. You can simply click right here to start the process. Of course, step one is to enter an email. If you don't already have one, you can create an account. You'll also need to set up your password and sign in. Of course, with any account, you should have two-step verification, which I already set up. And once you're signed into Autodesk, it'll take you to this page. Of course, input your email and hit continue. If it does not give you a valid email address, notice I'm hitting spacebar and backspacing. If you try again, bang, it'll work. Of course, then fill in the rest of your information and hit continue. Fill in the rest of the information and of course, agree and submit. This is the tricky one. Even if you've already installed Fusion, you have to hit download now. I'm going to hit no thanks on this because of the video. If you have not installed it before, of course, you do need to download the installer. Since I had already done that, I'm going to hit cancel at this time. I'm going to quickly launch Fusion right now since I finished that step. And when Fusion launches, you need to sign in. Of course, I'm going to complete those steps once again. I'm going to skip the stay signed in and hit sign in. Once again, I have two-step on, so I do need to do that. And now we can hit open product, which does take a moment, especially if you're used to Tinkercad opening. And bang, there is Fusion for personal use. I do want to give you a note about this in your browser window. It pops up the identity manager, and I click the button to say don't ask again, saying that I always wanted to allow it. I'm assuming that you're just learning Fusion, so let me show you my favorite setting to change under Preferences. And on the General, scroll down and find the Pan and Zoom shortcuts. I recommend that you switch these to look like Tinkercad. Of course, I do want to let you know there are tons of other features you can mess with as well. That's just the one that made it feel most normal to me. All right, so real quickly, I have bounced to Tinkercad. I'm going to tell you that everything in Sketch that I've sent to Fusion, it'll get there, but I can't do Fillets. It just won't let me because of how complex it is when these come in. It's best to actually draw these in Fusion. I just don't use Fusion that much yet. All right, so let me show you this really quick. I have backed out of full screen so you've got a better view. I'm grabbing these two parts that are a simple union. Of course, they are the cube and the pyramid. I'm going to choose Export, Autodesk Fusion. It was only the selected shape. You can see it right here. I wait for it to arrive. I'm going to click Send, and I'm going to open in a local desktop. You'll see the little spinning thing right here, and you'll need to wait patiently as the launcher starts. Eventually, this pops up, and after a little bit of a wait, Fusion will open. Just a reminder, it does take a moment for Fusion to fully load. If you're used to Tinkercad like me, you'll be clicking on stuff trying to get going just a little bit faster. So now that I'm in here, I just want to show you how awesome Fusion can be. I'm going to grab the entire project by selecting it. I'm going to press F for Fillets, and then I'm just going to type a number. If I type 0.5 and press Enter, bang, that shape is immediately rounded. Trying to do that by hand in Tinkercad would have been crazy difficult. I'm going to do Control Z to undo it, and I want to show you this too. Once again, grab it all. F for Fillet, and instead of typing a number, you can also drag. Now notice you can go too far, and it becomes not possible. It showed an error down there on the corner, but I can simply nudge back and find the possible adjustments. Notice the one we're using here is 2.5. We could type that if we wanted as well. Of course, there are tons of other cool things you can explore, but I'm just giving you an intro. If we click OK, bam, check that part out. Of course, I do not have a need for it, but it's pretty impressive how quickly Fusion can make it come together. Real quickly, I will highlight up here. This is where you'll often see that there's updates. Notice there was a workflow disrupted. I have no idea what that is. I am going to show you this quickly too. If I close this, it says, do you want to save it? I'm going to say, yes, I do. I'm not going to turn on autosave. I don't care about the name. I'm just going to hit save. But then I want you to see that this uses up one of our 10 projects. Well, if you want your 10 projects back, all you do is click the handle and switch it to read-only. Once you mark it read-only, the projects still exist, but you've got all 10 of your projects back available to you. So let's wrap this up really quick. Of course, I gave you clear, concise steps for how to sign up for Fusion personal use. Then I showed you how from Tinkercad, you can use Send to Fusion to make some pretty awesome projects. Now, if you want to be an expert at Fusion, I highly recommend you visit CADclass.org. They have fantastic courses. I have a coupon code that you can use. If you use 25 HL Tinkercad, it'll get you 25% off any course on the site. Now, I do also want to highlight my Fusion playlist. You can check it out with the bit.ly up above. I have a few tutorials, and of course, that list will be growing. Of course, friends, I also want to thank everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, make sure you pay attention to those members-only posts. Also, a massive shout-out to everybody that supports me via Patreon. There are more than 330 members. It has a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions, post designs, gain skills. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you like, hype, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.